Hey, all. Thanks for tuning in. It's Full Moon Yoga tonight, so just flow along. We're at Vertex Fitness. Really big thanks to them for letting us stream live tonight. So if anyone has any questions post-class, please don't hesitate to hit me up. All right, peace. Thank you. Coming into space.
to come into a moon salute. So press into the palms, hands come down towards the third eye, pull the elbows forward. Big inhale here. Exhale, pull ourselves down and over the tops of our heads. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Step that left foot back into a runner's lunge. Big inhale. Hold here. So press back through that heel, pull forward with that shin, and then step that right foot back. Press back into a down dog. Big inhale here. I'm going to drop down to a table, so knees come down to the mat. And then knees come wide, we're going to press back into that child's pose again. Hands come out in front. Big inhale here. Crawl the fingertips out in front a little bit more. Pull back through the hips. And then hands are slowly going to walk back towards the knees. Knees can shift to the center line. And then we're going to come back up into kneeling. Hands come up here. And then we're going to slowly drop down through the elbows, pulling on the low belly, coming into praying child. Elbows come down to the mat. And then hands are going to come back behind the head. You can crawl the elbows out a little bit more and pull back the head. You can stretch out through the triceps. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Hands come back to the mat. And then we'll slowly pull ourselves forward, coming into a forward-facing dog. So dropping down through the hips, pulling forward with the chest, pressing down through the tops of the feet. Big inhale here. Exhale, roll over the toes, press back into down dog. Pedal out through the feet, press into the hands, check out the elbows. And then take that right leg back behind. Big inhale. And we're going to step that right foot up to meet that right hand. Press back through that heel. Big inhale here. And then we're slowly going to step that left foot up to meet our right. Inhale, flat backs. Exhale, come down and over the tops of the thighs. Inhale, we'll sweep ourselves up to standing. Moon salute again. And then hands pull down to the heart center. How you feeling? Good? Great. Inhale, arms come up overhead again. Moon salute. Hands come down to that third eye. Exhale, come down and over the tops of the thighs. Pull in on the low belly. Inhale, flat back. Hands to shins. Hold here. Think about grounding down through the big toe mounds. Don't grip with the toes. Maybe think about picking the toes up off the mat and then putting the big toe down, followed by all the other subsequent toes. Big inhale. Exhale, slowly come down and over the legs. Hands come down to the mat. I'm going to set that right foot back behind us first this time. Big inhale here. Press back through the heel, pull forward with the shin. Go ahead and step that left foot back. Holding here. And then pressing back into down dog. Pedal out through the feet. Big inhale. Exhale, we're going to drop down to that table. And then we're going to come back down into that child's pose. So press back here. Hands crawl out in front. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. Crawl the fingers out a little bit further. And then we'll slowly walk our hands back towards our legs. Bring the knees back into the center line. And bring yourself up to that kneeling position again. Press down through the tops of the feet, tops of the shins, arms come up overhead. Moon salute. Come down. Pull in on the low belly. Take the sit bones back towards the heels. Engage the low belly. Bring the elbows down to the mat. And then praying child's hands come back behind the head in prayer. You can crawl out with the elbows. You can lengthen through the triceps. Big inhale. Exhale. Hands come down to our mat. And then we're slowly going to shift ourselves forward. Exhale, lower the toes and press back into down dog. Hands are wide, hips are Inhale, flat back. Exhale, come down and over the tops of the thighs. And then inhale, scoop ourselves back to standing. Hands come into prayer, or to that moon salute, and then hands can come down to heart center. So kind of a different flow, just to kind of keep in mind. So usually moon flows aren't taught. Yoga is kind of lax sometimes, space of the divine feminine, so it's important to kind of know that. A lot of sun salutations are taught, but not a lot of moon. So a little bit different, but we'll do another moon flow and we'll kind of go from there, okay? So learn something new every day. Inhale, arms sink up overhead. You can either bring the hands into the prayer or you can interlock the fingers and release the index fingers and bring them up to the sky. Big inhale here. And then on our exhale, we're going to take our body over to that left hand side. Big inhale. Take that left armpit towards the front of the room. Right hip towards the front of the room. Big inhale. Biceps are back by the ears. You can also modify here. You can bring this hand down to the side and kind of reach and stretch here. Exhale, bring yourself back to center. Come up and out of the waist. Big inhale. Exhale, same thing on that opposite side. Use the strength of the hands to pull you into the posture a little bit more. And we're not bending from our hips, we're extending. Big inhale. Friend Mike Massey taught me that in terms of about back bends and forward bends. You guys should check him out. 33 degree yoga. Big inhale. But he's out of Massachusetts. Exhale. Go ahead and release that hand. Bring it down to the side. Press and pull with the fingertips. Big inhale. Exhale. Slowly we bring ourselves back to center line. We're going to ground down through that left leg and we're going to step back with that right foot. So coming into a high lunge here, first to start, big inhale. Exhale, drop that heel, open up into a warrior two, big inhale. And then exhale, you're gonna turn those toes to center, and then turn those toes out. So, yeah, there we go. Goddess pose. Yeah, you can move around as much as you want. So I like to kind of come down into the goddess, right? So about the integrity of the spine. You have a tendency to really want to jut out here. Think about pulling up and in. Hands come here. And then inhale, reach up and star. Exhale, squat down. Inhale up. Exhale, squat. We go for eight. For seven. For six. For five. For four, for three, for two, and one. Hold here. Hands can come down to the inside of the thighs. Drop down through that left shoulder. Press into the legs. Open them up a little bit. Back to center line. Opposite leg on that opposite shoulder. Slowly come back to center. We're gonna bring ourselves up. And then we're going to pivot on our heels towards the right leg. Nice deep inhale. We're going to slowly open up here. So keep the hips turned towards the front of the room. Triangle, y'all. So reach out through those fingertips. Bring that right hand down to shin. Left hand comes up to the sky. Big inhale. Engage the quadricep muscles, but think about not locking out the knee, but rather wrapping the muscles around the bones. Big inhale. And then exhale, we're going to turn our torso so it comes towards that right leg. And then just do a little mini half hop up our mats, coming into the pyramid. So torso straight on, you come down and over the top of that thigh. Pull back through that right hip. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Hands are going to come down to the mat. Hop back that left foot. Pull forward that right shin. Little lunge. Beginning up here. Hold. You can take both hands to the inside of that right foot. ahead and do a little mini half hop off the mat, coming into the pyramid towards that left leg. Pull forward with the chest. Nice deep inhale. And then we're going to slowly scoop ourselves up. Hop back a little bit with that back foot again. And then we're going to open up into that triangle again. So reach fingertips, big inhale. Hand comes down to the shin. Opposite hand comes up to the sky. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, we slowly pull ourselves back up. And then we come back into that goddess squat. Knees are wide. Settle down into it. Hands come here to the sides. And then we inhale up in the star. Exhale, squat. Inhale up. Exhale, squat. We go for eight. For seven. For six. For five. For four. For three. Last two. And one. Big inhale here. Hands can come down to get inside of those thighs again. Drop down through that left shoulder. And then go ahead and slowly drop down through that right. Bring yourself back to center line. Bring yourself back to standing. And you can heel toe those feet back into center. Inhale, arms come up. Reach up. Go ahead and bring yourself over to the right hand side. Holding here. And then slowly come back to center line. Same thing again, big inhale. Exhale, over to the opposite side. Hold the fingertips. Slowly come back to center. Move slowly. Hands come back. Then hands come down to back center. So we're going to do the same thing again, but we're going to leave that left foot this way. So inhale, arms sweep. Move slowly. Hands come to heart or to that third eye. Hands move down to heart center. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead. Interlock your fingers, maybe interlock a different option, right? So interlock, change up the grip a little bit. Yeah, release the index fingers, big inhale. On our exhale, we're going to slowly pull ourselves forward to the right hand side, big inhale. Exhale, hold, one more time, big inhale. And you can always drop that right arm, slowly we come back to center line, inhale up. Exhale, same thing on that opposite side. Use the strength of the hands to pull you over. Think about balancing the weight between the big toe mound, baby toe mound, and heel, big inhale. Exhale, hands move down, heart center. Let's go ahead and step back with that left foot this time. Big inhale. Holding here.
Coming into triangle, left foot straight in front.
hinge the hip. Engage the muscles in the leg, right? Wrap them around the bones. Hinge here, hand comes down to shin. Opposite hand comes up to the sky, inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, inhale. Exhale, pivot with the hips and turn the torso down to the mat. You can do that little mini half hop coming into your pyramid. Check in with that left hip. Hands can come down to the outside of that foot. If you ever wanted to use blocks, you could always put blocks here and come and hang out. Big inhale, pull back through that left hip, big inhale. And exhale. Hop back at that right foot. Come into that low lunge. Big inhale here. Exhale, pivot on the ball of that foot, or on the heel of that left foot. And then you're gonna flip that right foot up to the sky. Skin basana, hands come to the inside of that left leg. Big inhale here. Exhale, we move through center line. Skin basana on that opposite side. Big inhale. Those toes, or you can practice pointing the toes too, but keeping the chest up, whatever's comfortable. And then go ahead, move back to center and pivot on the heel of that back foot, turn on the heel of that front. So we're moving towards our right leg this time, big inhale. Holding here. And then go ahead and do a little mini half hop of the mat. Coming back into pyramid here on this right hand side, big inhale. Drop down through the chest. And then inhale, we scoop ourselves up. And open up in to what is triangle. You can hop back that foot a little bit into the hip. Hand comes down to shin, opposite hand comes up to the sky, big inhale here.
Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Step, step.
lowering and lifting, big inhale. Exhale, roll over the toes, press back to down dog. Keep your high hands wide. Take that right leg back behind, first big inhale. Spot that right bum, step the right foot up to move the right hand, come back to that left foot. You can drop down to that left knee, flip those toes flat, inhale up. Exhale, move the salute here, hands move down to heart center, press that leg away. If you can, lift your back toes, we're gonna pull that knee back behind you a little bit, and we're gonna press down into the top of the back foot flat. So use this leg for brace and press up, so you can stretch up the front part of the back, big inhale. Exhale, go ahead and lower down. Hands come down to the mat, flip the back toes, and then go ahead and step that right foot back to meet the left. Shift forward, lowering and lifting, big inhale. Exhale, roll over the toes, press back to down dog, hands are wide, hips are high. Left leg comes back behind, big inhale. Exhale, let's shift forward. Left foot comes up to meet left hand, press back through the heel, big inhale. Exhale, drop down to that back knee, toes flip flat, inhale up. Exhale, hands come down to the spoon salute, hands come down to heart center. Grab onto the top part of the thigh, press it away. And then maybe pull that knee back behind a little bit more before you press down to the top of that back foot and take that back knee up off the mat. Big inhale. Exhale, slowly lower. Hands come down to the mat, toes flip. Step that left foot back to meet the right. Shift back with the heels, pull forward, lowering and lifting. Big inhale. Exhale, roll the toes, press back. So go ahead and slowly come down to our knees. Flip the toes flat, walk the hands back. We'll come back into that kneeling space. Arms come up overhead. Pulling up the low belly, come down with the elbows. Take the sit bones back towards the heels. And then take the hands back behind the head in prayer, very tight. Hands come back down to the mat. We'll pull ourselves forward again, coming back into that forward-facing dog. And then exhale, come back down to the knees, take them wide and press back into child's head. Draw the fingertips out in front, just a little bit more. Shift back and forth. Slowly walk the hands back towards the knees. Take the knees together and we'll just rock over onto our seat. Coming into butterfly. So soles of the feet come together to touch. Come onto the front part of the sit bone so you can really like take the flesh and move it back behind you. Hold on to the toes. And then we're going to pull forward with our heart. And if you can, you can hook the front part of your elbows and your shins. So thinking about coming into this a little bit flatter back, big inhale. And don't think about grounding down, coming down to the knees, but dropping down from the femur bones. Exhale, and slowly come out of that. Take the legs facing wide. Again, you can move the flesh up the back side, side to side. Shift forward a little bit. We'll widen this space. And then we'll slowly slowly walk the hands back to the place. You kind of come up underneath your knees a little bit. And then jump in. And then take the legs out in front. Move the sit bones back behind again. Arms come up high. And then on the exhale, pull in on the low belly and bring yourself over the tops of the thighs. You can grab onto the bottoms of the feet, pull forward with the chest. Pull in on that low belly. Again, think about leaving your heart in this one, so you're coming into a normal flat back. And just think about relaxing and releasing through the hamstrings. Big inhale. And exhale. Slowly walk the hands up the legs. And scoot forward with the seat. And come down onto the back. Soles of the feet come flat to the mat. Hands come down to the sides. Tips of the fingers will graze the back side of the heels. We'll come into a quick bridge pose here. Pull, you can kind of press down into the forearms and roll the shoulders underneath you. And then press up through the hips. So pressing down through the soles of the feet. Big inhale. Think about the shins kind of pulling forward. Big inhale here. If you want to, you can interlock the fingers behind you. Kind of roll onto the shoulders to pop up through the chest. Big inhale. Too long after that, I was kind of moved by life to start doing full classes on the full moon, kind of taking over space in different spots out in Boston. And started off with just me and my friend Marlene Boya, another incredible yoga teacher, joined me. And then all of a sudden, there are like hundreds of people. Right? So, understanding the power of the moon, kind of the power of the divine feminine. So, I think both listen to this as long as the video works.
to the effect that they really don't need a soul. Okay. And she's very sensitive to him. So, you'll see. And she goes and she sits on the moon and spends time in your
power. And while she does that, all the sweet water on the earth dries up. And they came to us. They came to the house. They came in to you. They came broken. They came created. Nothing is broken because love is such. And when they realize that nothing is working, they run back up to the little mind, the one who owns the whole spectrum of the rainbow, the owner of the day. And they complain, you know, would you send us down here for a game accomplished? And all the mind says, somebody's missing from this crew that I sent down there. Where is Oshun? And the comment was made, who needs her? And that's when Olumide summons Oshun from her resting place where she's kicking back at it into her class. When she arrives, she explains that they insulted her. They were stupid enough to think they didn't need fresh water. They didn't need such stuff. And so the Most High makes them apologize to her. And I love this part, in the Odu, it says she accepted their apology and she told them, don't let it happen again. Okay. And as a result of that, she had decided whether she wanted to be involved again. And so she turned herself on herself and gave birth to the Levi. Now, I want to say very, very clear that Oshiro Tulu is a very, very important story in my tradition. All the stories we see, when they hit trade, when they arrive in front of us, we look for the manifestation of the story around us. To have Oshiro leave us is a very, very dangerous thing, okay? And we see it in things like fracking, what's happening to our world. We see it in things like the way that they are raping the queen bee. Honey is sacred to Oshun. We see it in the sex trafficking of children that's going on this planet. All these things we read as signs that we have pissed Oshun off, okay? And so for the last 10 or 12 years, there have been priests all over the world going to the river, going to places where the river's dry, and making offerings and begging Oshun to come back to us. All this is about wanting to recognize the power of the divine feminine.
Peace and love, y'all.